Hi guys, and welcome to this new episode. Today I want to share with you a little experience I'm doing for myself, but I thought that some of you might be interested in. I've decided to push a roll of Kodak Tri-X up to ISO 6400. So basically 6000 ISO more than it's supposed to be shot at. I wanted to see how the film would react in such an extreme pushing, and I'm sure some of you have been wondering how it would look like. So I've decided to make a quick video to show you the process and the result of the pictures, obviously. So all the images that you're gonna see have been shot on my Leica M6, and for those of you interested, the lens is a Voigtlander Nocton 35mm 1.4. So yeah, the entire roll was shot with that. I've tried to do it in different environments, so there is a bit of low light, of course, to shoot it with that kind of ISO, but also in bright daylight. That was a bit challenging because the M6 is limited to 1,000 of a second, and sometimes I was reaching the limit. I would have needed 2,000 or even 4,000. But yeah, hopefully some pictures will turn out okay, we'll see later. For the developer, I'm gonna use a bit of the E4 DDX that I have left. I hope it's still good because I've had this bottle open for quite some time now. But yeah, hopefully it will turn out okay. I've developed some rolls a few weeks ago and they turned out fine, so let's see with this one. About the dilution I'm gonna use, I've checked on a massive depth chart, and luckily there is exactly the dilution and everything I need with this chemical. So with the Kodak Tri-X, when you push it to 6400, you need to do a dilution of 1 plus 4. That means that in total we have 5 doses of liquid. They're gonna be 1 dose of the DDX and 4 doses of water. So I've made a quick calculation, and with the Patterson tank that I'm using, when you develop one roll, you need approximately 300 milliliters, that's the minimum. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put 60 milliliters of the developer, the DDX, and the rest of water. And now the thing is, it's not really a trick, but yeah, the development time when you push so much is really extended. It's almost doubled for what I do usually. Here it's going to be 25 minutes. So I'm going to do the same process that I always do. I'm going to do 1 minute of agitation during the first minute. Then I'm going to let it rest and do 4 inversions every minute. Of course, I'm going to speed this up because I don't want you to suffer during all those 25 minutes. Then we're going to be doing a stop bath and the fixer. And there is also something for the to have the surface of the film clean. It's like, I forgot the name, I'll put you in the description or somewhere on the screen. Yeah, it's just to have a clean negative and dust-free and mark-free. Yeah, that's about it. If you want to know more about how to develop black and white film, I'm not gonna really go into detail into this video, it's just gonna be quick, but I'm gonna put in the description a link to a video that I've done before that I'll show you step by step how to proceed and how you should do. So yeah, I'm gonna get started, mix the chemical and start doing agitation. Then I'm gonna just let the pictures on the screen with some nice music, hopefully, so you guys can have a look. And if you want to have a better look of the picture, there's gonna be a link to the article, to the blog, where you can see, you can have a better look on the picture and take some time to study them if you like. So yeah, that's about it. I'll leave you from here, and now enjoy this episode and see you soon, guys. Bye. We'll be right back.